This is Andreas and it's an exciting day as we are going to write our first command in Python. In this lecture we are going to learn how to use the IDLE program that comes bundled with our Python interpreter. We'll be writing our code using the IDLE program. So let's first launch it. You can search for it by typing IDLE in the search box. Once it's found, click on IDLE Python to launch it. The Python shell appears in our screen. A shell is a program that lets you type instructions into the computer. Much like the terminal or command prompt on OS X and Windows respectively. We can enter one command at a time. The shell waits for a command from the user, executes and returns the result of the execution. After this, the shell waits for the next command. The line starting with three greater than symbols. Let's do some examples. Type. +10. Enter. The cell returns the answer 15. Now type. +5 > 1. Enter. True. You are asking the cell if 5 is greater than 1. The cell replies true. So the cell is good for running one command at a time. It is a very convenient tool for testing Python commands, especially when we are first getting started with the language. However, if you exit from the Python shell and enter it again, all the commands you type will be gone. In addition, you cannot use the Python shell to create an actual program. But what if you want to write an entire program? The answer is the file editor. To code an actual program, you need to write your code in a text file and save it with a .py extension. This file is known as a Python script. You can open the file editor from File and then New File. It's similar to a text editor and it lets you type in many instructions, save the file and run the program. Keep in mind that the interactive shell window will always be the one with the three greater than symbols prompt. Instead, the file editor window will not have this prompt. In the next lecture, we are going to write our first program. Thanks for watching.